So today I'm going to be talking about, coming out of showers and reading such nonsense is never good. So, I'm trying to write and I have a non-stopping debate on Twitter with a bunch of anti-Semites that hate on Israel and Jews. And they frequently quote Haaretz. Of course, the toilet paper, the trash of publications in Israel. And there are two specific articles that I want to mention here. The first one, and it's not the one I'm making the video about, is how Haaretz incites Jews against Jews. And here, the headline is, Israel solidarity with diaspora Jews died well before Pittsburgh. Sorry, but, and they hate on Netanyahu for praising Trump. And the thing is, it's not really wrong. Israeli Jews are making concessions for diaspora Jews, even though diaspora Jews, most of them don't care about Israel. They vote on policies against Israel. They support terrorists that want to destroy Israel. Let's just say that it is not a good thing. It's not a good relationship. Israel has more loyalty towards diaspora Jews and cares more about diaspora Jews than a lot of diaspora Jews care about Israel. And it's growing, there's a growing number of diaspora Jews that do not care about Israel, and they vote against Israel on every single policy. They support terrorists. They support people who want to murder Jews. And Haaretz is only spreading more misinformation, and it's normal that they will not support Israel because they are basing their assumptions on this kind of trash publications that just want makes me want to throw my cell phone into the wall or something. This incitement is disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting. They dare say that Israeli Jews do not support diaspora Jews when, in fact, diaspora Jews are well off, are well cared for in most cases, and they are so comfortable that they vote on measures that endanger Israeli Jews that every single day have to face the threat of rockets, of bombs, of stabbings, and they vote for politicians and policies that endanger Israelis. So, stop inciting Jews against Jews, Haaretz. I really hope Netanyahu or someone really kicks out Haaretz. First and foremost, they have Nazi shareholders. They spread a lot of misinformation about Israel, about Judaism to the world. They freaking promote the Tamimi terrorists and give them platform. They pay for them. Haaretz is the most, the trashiest publication ever. So the other article, and this one I'm going to read from, is from an idiot, Shlomo Sand, who pretends to be a scholar, but knows nothing of history. Knows nothing about anything. No wonder Tel Aviv University is becoming the joke internationally that it is. You see how much hate and how much students from that particular institution are going against their families and supporting terrorists. And it's not the first idiot that is against Israel that gets hired by that university. They are indoctrinating Jewish children into hating themselves. they are spreading misinformation and turning everyone into leftist identity politics and turning them against their own history. So the title of this article by Shlomo Sand reads, "The Twisted Logic of the Jewish Historic Right to Israel." There's a doozy right there. Our political culture insists on seeing the Jews as the direct descendants of the ancient Hebrews. But the Jews never existed as a people, still less as a nation. Right there, here's a very problematic statement. First, Jews were and are the direct descendants of Hebrews. Jews have kept Hebrew in almost every single place they went to. They brought Hebrew to Portugal. We have Hebrew words in Portuguese, even. We have Jewish traditions that transpired to Portuguese culture. And wherever Jews went to, they brought Hebrew and Aramaic. Yiddish has a mix of Hebrew. Ladino had a mix of Hebrew. Jews, wherever they go, have Hebrew in their heads. They always have Hebrew vocabulary in their heads. And every single thing that unites Jews makes them a nation. I don't know what retarded notion you have of nation, but Jews are a nation. I enjoy the vacillations of Cain dance, even if I don't always understand them. I have the highest esteem for his intellectual honesty, even if at times, perhaps like everyone, he tries to resolve contradictions with lame arguments. However, before going into the heart of the matter, I must pause over an annoying mistake. I'm certain that at bottom it's not deliberately misleading but a folly concerning my writings. In the article from Rabbi Zionism to Egalitarian Zionism, November 9th, Gans writes, "Because according to Sam, there is purportedly no genetic continuity between ancient and modern Jewry, it follows that the Jewish nationhood engendered by Zionism is a total fabrication, a nationhood created out of thin air." And again, we already see that this scholar is again following the Khazarian myth and all that nonsense, which, by the way, has been debunked by countless studies that have connected mainly the main line of Ashkenazi Jews, foreign Jews, to the Middle East and to all other Jews. There is a very close genetic relationship between Israeli Jews, between Sephardic Jews, and Jews that never left the Middle East. If my assumption that Gans has perused my books is correct, he appears to have read them both too quickly and at a diagonal. Since the publication of my first book, The Invention of the Jewish People, a decade ago, okay, I need to read this nonsense, I have made it a point of emphasizing that it's not only Jews who don't possess a common DNA, which, by the way, is debunked by countless studies that show that Jews, all Jews, share a very close genetic relationship, not only amongst themselves, but also with Druze and other people from the Levant area and the Middle Eastern area, and even they are more closely related to those that are originate from that area than the Palestinians are. Palestinians are more closely related to Egyptians and Arabs than anyone in the area of Israel, Syria, whereas Jews are not only closely related amongst each other, they are also closely related to the other indigenous people of the area. So it's quite interesting to note that. Okay, neither do all other union groups that claim to be peoples or nations, besides which I have never thought that genetics can come for national rights. For example, the French are not direct descendants of the Gauls, just as the Germans are not the offspring of the Teutons or the ancient Aryans, even if until a little more than half a century ago, many idiots believed just that. One trait that all peoples have in common. All peoples, oh gosh, I don't know why it sounds so wrong. Is that they are retroactive inventions with no distinctive genetic traits. Oh boy. Another case. The chief problem that genuinely disturbs me is that I live in a similar political and pedagogical culture that continues persistently to see the Jews as the direct descendants of the ancient Hebrews. First and foremost, you're not a geneticist and you understand nothing about genetics, and it shows in this. And then you also show complete ignorance in terms of history while claiming to be an historian. But let's not lose time, because this is a mouthful and there is a lot to read. The founding myth of Zionism, which proceeds in an unbroken line from Max Nordau and Arthur Rupin to voice some geneticists in several Israeli universities and at Yeshiva University in New York, at acts as the principal ideological glue for the nation's everlasting unity, and today more than ever, the justification for the Zionist settlement colonization. Choose your preferred term, they mean the same thing. Is the meta paradigm that is expressed in the declaration of the establishment of the state, namely, we were here, we were uprooted, we came back. Okay, so we can already see where his allegiance lies. He's trying to disprove if he was trying to disprove a single point of connection of Jews to Israel, he might actually have some success, but he's not only trying to disprove Judaism and the Jewish nation as a unity, he is trying to disprove historical connection to Israel, and he's also trying to disprove genetic connection amongst Jews, which has been proven time and time again by different select studies. And if that wasn't enough, the cultural aspects remained even in diaspora, even with persecutions and attempts at suppressing every single Jewish trait. Even crypto-Jews keep something Jewish. Like, my family was converted, I don't know how long ago, and we still have Jewish habits that we don't know that where they came from, but we have those habits. For instance, we don't have our beds turned towards the door, we can't walk over people that are alive, we must walk back. There are several things that still are Jewish that remain despite our complete disconnection from Judaism a few centuries ago. So, he is wrong on so many levels. A lot of Jews know, no matter how much the Crusades, the Inquisition tried to destroy Judaism, Jews always kept their identity. And those that were stripped of their identity show signs of Judaism even decades, centuries later, after their families were forced into converting into Christianity or Islam. Full disclosure, even when I believe mistakenly that the Jewish people, and he puts that under was exiled by the Romans in 70 CE or 130 CE, I didn't think that this conferred on the Jews some sort of imagined historic rights to the Holy Land. Okay, this is a mouthful. He clearly, so at first he claims that he was a rabid Zionist, and now he says that the historical connection to Israel doesn't confer Jews a right to Israel, which is stupid. Like, I mean, for centuries, Jews have always been pariahs everywhere they went to. They have never been seen as anything other than Jews. They have spent millennia being sent back to where they came from. And now the very same people that told Jews centuries ago to come back where they came from are telling them that they don't belong in Israel. Which, by the way, you never accepted Jews as national citizens of wherever they came from. They were there sometimes, even before the foundation of those states, and yet they were never considered citizens of said states, or they were seen as second-class citizens, and always identified as Jews. Jews from Judea, Israel. So, don't say that the fact that Jews were exiled millennia ago from Israel doesn't confer them the right to come back. The single fact that for millennia they were always considered as being from Israel shows that their historical connection to Israel never faded, and the argument can be made that they belong in Israel. Also, whether you believe or not in the Torah can be seen as the oldest property title and the oldest constitution in all of humanity. So, I'm sorry there, you lose. If we seek to organize the world as it was 2,000 years ago, we'll turn it into one big madhouse. Why not bring Native Americans back to Manhattan, for example, or restore the Arabs to Spain? Oh my god. Oh my freaking god. You're so ignorant. First, Arabs didn't invade the Iberian Peninsula until after the Romans invaded. And why? Because the Spanish side of the Iberian Peninsula betrayed the Lusitanian side that was fighting them. So, no, Arabs are themselves invaders. They were not native to this area. So, please, before you give examples, at least study some history. Actually, Jews were in Iberia before Arabs ever were here. They came in with Phoenicians and other traders. So, traders as in T-R-A-D-E-R-S. I know my accent is a little weird, so I apologize. So, you're wrong on that count, too. And the Serbs to Kosovo. Of course, such twisted logic of historic... Oh gosh, I'm sorry, but I clicked on something. But then again, he is claiming that Arabs first founded and exist making arguments that don't make any sense. The Lusitanians, their culture was destroyed, but their genetic descendants are still here. The Iberos, their culture was destroyed, and absorbed by the Roman culture, and later the Arab culture, and later Franks, and the Germans, and we have so much invasions here that, you know, it doesn't make sense, but again, he has to make these absurd comparisons to detract from the fact that he's wrong. Hang on, let me try not to click again on that thing. Okay, Yeshiva University, I'm close. Of course, such twisted logic of historic right will also commit us to supporting the continued colonization of Hebron, Jericho, and Bethlehem. Okay, so Hebron has always been a Jewish place. It's in the Bible for centuries. And there is a historic connection of Jews to Hebron for centuries, Jericho and Bethlehem as well. And if you if you really care about Bethlehem, why don't you care about the Christians that were uprooted from Bethlehem now to allow the Muslims to live there? Bethlehem was basically stolen from the Christians and Jews and was invaded by Arabs from Jordan, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, and that areas, because they wanted to prevent Israel from being founded. As I pursued my research, my realization that the Exodus from Egypt never happened, and that the inhabitants of the Kingdom of Judah were not exiled by the Romans, left me nonplussed. Okay, there are so many things wrong with this article that I don't even know where to start. This guy is a complete moron. I don't even understand how the University of Tel Aviv has him on his payroll brainwashing kids and teaching inaccurately history, and worse, history of Jewish people. So first and foremost, the Exodus. Actually, there is historical evidence that places Jews in Egypt as far as 4,000 before the current era, and there is archaeological evidence that they were in Egypt around between 4,000 before the current era until 3,500 before the current era. So that's a lie. And now, and that the inhabitants of the Kingdom of Judah were not exiled by the Romans. Again, there is actually proof of the migratory routes from that Jews took from Israel. Of course, not all Jews were exiled, and different ways of migration happened. Some were exiled by the Arabs, some were exiled by Romans, and you have a continuous movement. You have migration from Sephardics to Iberia, you have migrations that predate the Romans, and you have migrations that were caused by the Romans. Then you also have the Ashkenazi movement that went from the other side, that went from the continent. But again, there is no room. And he's just stupid. He is propagating anti-Semitic myths, and it's really disgusting to see someone who clearly has Jewish origins to propagate those lies. There is not one study by a historian who specializes in antiquity that recounts that exile, or any serious historiographic study that reconstructs a mass migration from the place. theory. There are thousands of historians commenting on this. There is a lot of evidence that places that talks about the Jewish migrations from Israel in several waves, and I don't know, it's stupid that he claims that there is no proof when there is numerous historical accounts of the Jewish exodus from Israel, and of course not all Jews left, and a lot of Jews were first converted to other religions, and others left in different migrant waves. They didn't all leave at the same time. There were waves of migration, and there is historical accounts of that. I don't know. He's purposefully ignoring historical accounts to make it seem as a fraud. Because of course, when you're trying to create a narrative, you will deny everything that doesn't support your narrative. The exile is a formative event that never took place, otherwise it would be the subject of dozens of research studies. Judahite farmers, who constituted an absolute majority of the population at the first century current era, were not seafarers like the Greeks or the Phoenicians, and did not spread across the world. That's why. Actually, many Jews came in with Phoenicians to the Iberian Peninsula even before the Jewish exodus. There is evidence of Jews in the Iberian Peninsula even before the Romans invaded Israel. So, no. That is wrong as well. Jews may not have been like Greeks or Phoenicians, but they could certainly have taken a ride on Phoenician boats, as they did, and come to Europe. They were here. They were in the Iberian Peninsula for centuries. It was a Jahwist monotheism, which since the Hasmonean era had become a dynamic religion, imagining conversion, which laid the foundations for the Jews' age-old existence of home group. And again, this is again the Khazarian myth, and it has already been thoroughly debunked. There are numerous genetic studies that prove that both Ashkenazi Jews, Sephardic Jews, have connection to other Jews from the Middle East and Jews from all around the world, and there is a close genetic similarity between Jews, Druze, Syrians, and all the population.